What is up everyone, here is SelfDevs TV. In this video we are going to create the functionality to upvoting a post. Why have I called it upvoting instead of voting? As you will see, this video will already getting very long because voting and upvoting is not as simple as you might think. As I also thought it would be very fast to implement, but it's not the case, which you will find out. So right now we have our posts, so just a side info, I only have Next.js here, we don't need two subs, just for this, for testing, with these two posts. And we want to have, at the end of the video, when I click here, it will constantly mark this upvote button and also increase the number here from the votes. And when I click it again, it will remove this vote, and also this should be back to gray, and also everything reflected in the backend in our database. Yeah, so let's get started, shall we? Okay, so here in the subreddit post component where we render each post, I want to create this functionality. So let's go here and create a function that is called upvote post. Later we will refactor this and rename it to vote post, because right now in this video we just handle upvoting posts. Okay, so the first thing I want to do here is imagine a user that wants to vote a post that has no permissions. What should happen? So let's try this out on actual Reddit. I think you will get redirected to a login page. Let me try that for you, log out. Okay, let me try. I click here. What happens? Reddit seems to be very slow today. That's my internet. Yeah, so when we click this button, a new dialog opens with either creating a new account or sign in. So I want to implement this by creating a new login page. And when the user clicks here, it will send to this login page when he clicks upvote but doesn't have isn't logged in. So let's write us a little comment. If the user is not logged in, redirect to a login page. So if there is no session, we need a session. And the session we get from the use session. I also decided to copy paste some imports, and so you don't have to watch me import this stuff every time. Here we get our session and our loading. So if we don't have a session, and also it's let me think, it's not loading, so it has finished with loading, then we want to redirect. So we also need our router. A lot of stuff here. Okay, it's already here, but we have to initialize the router. Router, use router. So then we want to router.push and then to a new page which we have yet to create called login. And then we also return. We don't want to run anything else here. That's this case. And right now for testing, let me go ahead and create a onClick function. that just calls upvote post for now. And this function is, I think I forgot to mention, is async because we will create a fetch logic here, and it also will receive the type. We don't need it right now, but for later, this is just the type. It can have two states, upvote or downvote. But I thought I'd put it in here because we need it later. Okay, and when we click and we are not logged in, we should get pushed to this page. So let's create this page under pages directly, login.tsx, and create a simple login page. Just to render something on the screen, we will return a layout, a div, and here we simply say you have to be logged in to use this feature. Then a button that says login. And also I want to have the functionality to go back, because the router from Next.js also has a functionality that it knows where the user came from and can push him back exactly to where he came from. So when he clicks the upvote button, he gets to this login page. But if he decided he don't want to log in, but he also won't don't want to upvote, he just clicks go back, then he's on the Reddit again. So let's this and now implement this. I import a few things here. It's the router, it's sign in from the client, from off, next off, and the use session. And then I also initialize it. And let's create a handle. No, here we start here on click. So when we click, what should happen? It should run the router back function that sends the user back where he came from. And when the user clicks login, it should first of all sign him in and then redirect him back to where he came from. So I create a simple function called handle login. The first thing I run here that I tested in another project, we have to use this first, because what happens is when I put a sign in first, next off will redirect to the main page. So he will get to the root page. I can show you this. I'll leave it like this. And here call handle login. Okay, that should be, it looks good. Yeah, and the reason why I imported this is imagine the user hits the login page manually. We want to redirect him to the main page because he don't has to log in here because he already is logged in when we have a session. That's just a catch. Yeah, let's try it out on our page. We log out. Then we go on Reddit and click upvote. And it knows we are not logged in, so we get thrown to this link. And when I click login, I would like to be back on our Next.js sub. Excuse me, I misclicked login. But what will happen is that we are getting thrown to the correct page. Okay, sorry. Maybe I missed something or I did something wrong in my other project, but it looks also very good to me, then maybe it doesn't care about the order. Let's try it out this way. Click here. Login. Okay, so it works either way, sorry guys. So that is exactly what we want. When the user logs in, he gets thrown back to where he came from, and now he doesn't get a click here and he doesn't get thrown to the login page because we are now logged in. So perfectly we handled this case if the user is not logged in. Okay, next thing would be let me think. Yeah, so the next thing really is we want to make an API call to an API we don't have yet, but let's catch this out really quickly. So we want to fetch, for example, so that's just rough code right now. API post and upvote. So we already have, not we have to create it and then post and upvote. And fetch can take an argument because we want to make a post request here because we want to change something. And the headers can be, I copy this over. And last but not least is the body which we receive in our backend route. What we really care here is the post ID because we have to save a new vote on this particular post. And we already get our post here. So post.id. And again, we won't need that right now, but I pass it in anyway, our type, because also the backend has to know if it is an upvote or a downvote. Okay. And I would say we will create our API route next. So API, then we create the folder post. And here I throw in upvote.ts and let's copy from subreddit. Yeah, start with this template here. Do this outside. Okay, so first we want to get the post ID. Get post ID from the request body. That's post ID equals req.body.postID. Or like this. And then I also want to know if the user is logged in or authenticated. So let's grab our session from await get session as in the request object here. Sorry, it has to be an async function. So that's our session. Okay, so first we check if we don't have a session, we return an error. So if no session, return registered status of 500, generic error, and the error can be you have to be logged in. And again, we really shouldn't hit this error on our frontend because we already have taken care here. So it should not get this error, but if a user tries to manually go to this route, it should give him an error when he's not logged in. Okay, and then when he can pass, then we will first get all the votes from the user. This will make sense in a few seconds why I fetch all posts now from the user. So we can do this by await Prisma dot vote find many. And we want to find all the posts where the user ID equals to our session user ID. Okay, so we have all the votes from our user. And what are we going to do with these votes? Now we check if the user has voted on this requested post. Save it in variable. So the variable is if it has posts, it's true or false. So this can true or false. We just check if the user has voted or not, because we have to decide what we do when the user has voted. We won't let him vote again, because on Reddit you can always upvote one time and not many times, like Clap works in medium.com, if you know this site. You can upvote many times, but not on Reddit. So we loop through our votes and we want to find where the current vote from the loop is the same as the post ID. The post ID which we provided here when we make the call. So we give the post where the user clicked, we receive it here. And now, has this user clicked on this post? Because a user can click many posts, but we care about this specific post. And if he has voted, we have now true, and we know that we can't let him vote again. And if he hasn't voted, we can just add a new vote. So let's handle this. So if the user has voted, remove the vote and return the removed vote. A good measure. So if he has voted, and I always like to difficult things to have this in my mind with comments. It makes it easier for me to transcribe it first and then get to the code part. So we call this deleted vote with prisma.vote.delete. Again, I love the Prisma API, how easy it is to work with it. We just want to delete the vote where the ID of the vote is the has voted.id. Because the cool thing is, this variable is not true or false. It is either it has a vote in here or it has not. So it's truthy or falsy, but also has the vote included here. So we can use this vote and get its ID and delete it. Yeah, so this has now the deleted vote, and all that's left is we return it and send it as JSON and also return out of here. Yeah, and then that's the try block if has voted. And then otherwise, just create a new vote and return it. So the user hasn't voted yet. That means we can create a new vote. Prisma vote create. the data. And again, TypeScript helps us here. And we go ahead and save the correct type into it. That's what we pass as second argument. I think we haven't destructured it. Const type body. We get post ID and type from the request body. The comments are also visible for you in the repo on GitHub. Link is in the description. So this is our vote type. The reason why it's underlined is because we don't have filled in all informations. It needs also a user. And here we use connect. Connect just makes a background API a search on the database and looks if it finds a session user ID, and we will find it because session is existing, and we'll connect the correct user on under the user property. And the same is true for post. We also have to connect the corresponding post that corresponds to the vote. And I always cast the post ID and these things to explicit numbers, because if I won't, I think it would complain. Here not, but sometimes it complains that it's maybe not the number. So I go ahead and hard cast it here. Yeah, and then when we have our data, the new vote, it's finished. We can send back this new vote. And also, yeah, that's it. Return here. And if this whole thing in here throws any error, then we send an error here. Status of 500. And the error, the JSON is just the error from here. And that should work fine. Our API, let's find out. So that's the API in place. And now we are going, we left here. So we create a fetch. And we should be able to, no, we can't see it right now because we don't have any functionality where we show it to the user that he has upvoted. So we also need the votes now here, and also on the subreddit API where we fetch the whole subreddit. We also want to include it here. And then we just show it in the way, in the form of, let's log it. I think I have an idea. We go to our sub TSX where we always get our fresh data, and we console log it here first. So we'll log. Do we have posts and the full sub? Okay, let's try it out. Refresh and open the console. Can we zoom here? Yeah, we can. Now I click on upvote. Hopefully it works. Okay. Get an error here. Getting circular structure JSON. That's really naughty error. Let me figure this out. Okay, guys, I think I found the error. I think it's one minor and one major error I made. The first error is I have to pass in an actual type here. So upvote. So this type will actually be a type because we also send it to our API. And the second most important bug is, so here I check for or pass in the session.userid, but session doesn't has a user ID. I console logged a few things. Here's the session object. It has user, but no user ID. And here is how you can add your custom things to the session object. I actually asked this on the next off GitHub questions, and this is a very good solution. So we go to our off next off setup, and this takes another argument here that's called callbacks. And one of these callbacks is the session, and you give it an async function that receives the session and the user. And then you can stick some things you want to have on the session object. For example, here our user ID, and that's just a user ID. Then you always have to return a promise.resolve with the session. And for this one, I'm restarting my server. And now, fingers crossed, we try it again. Let's give this a refresh. So we click it, nothing happens here. But now we should see that our session object has indeed a user ID object. And now we also can see a vote. And if we go to our studio and refresh here, yeah, we have our upvote here. Please don't get confused with this number. I tried it on my other workspace I always use before I create a new video. And in there, I already created for testing and other purposes many votes. So this has the vote of ID 71. On your project, this will be the ID 1 because it's your first vote, but it doesn't matter. You can see this is our single vote we have here. It belongs to our user selfdev. We also have another user here, hi cheese, that he logged into our working live example. It also is linked to our post, to the first post, and with my user and with this post. Okay, so API works now. If I click the upvote button another time, this should be gone. So I click it one time and refresh, and it's gone. And for good measure, try it once more, and it's here again. So that's exactly what we want from this. And now that we see that it's working on the back end, let's change this number to the vote number. I was thinking we give it a default number of 1. Because when you create a new post on subreddit, it also already has 1 upvote from yourself. So for now, just give it 1 or the votes in total length. So let me see how long's the video. Yeah, okay. So here where we hard coded the 3 in it. I want to put either the votes dot, okay, it's the post dot votes dot length. So if it has a length like 1, because 0 is a false value, it should display the length, or otherwise it should default to 1. So you see it's 1 for both. When I enter 0 here, we can see this has 1 vote because we voted on that. And when I vote on here, I click, it's not reflected on our UI yet. That will come in a few seconds. But if I lose focus, then regain focus, yeah, it updates the UI and it now has 1 post. And that's all we can have for now, because we just have this single user and every user can just vote once. When I click again, then I go to here and here, it reflects it. So this looks also very good. Let's give it the default value of 1. And we can see this when I publish this and a few users of you try to upvote these posts, you will see the thing rise, the number rise to 3, 4, 5 votes. Okay, now the last thing I want to do is mutate the cache. That's an interesting topic on our kinda main page here on the subreddit page. We have this SVR connection to that link, and in the background it uses a local cache. It's like the state from a React component, or imagine it like a Redux store. Okay, and the cool thing about this, we can edit this cache. We can update the cache, and it will instantly update our UI, and we don't have to wait for the API request. And I show you now how to do this. I want to put this out in its own variable. Let's call it sub-URL, because we need it in our post component. And then we just pass in sub-URL. And we pass it down here. Sub-URL is equal to the sub-URL. Of course, this will complain because we don't have it in our props yet. So this complains because we just said TypeScript, we just accept this argument, which we are going to change now. So I create the interface and I call it props, and this will receive the full post, which is here, and also a sub-URL property that's just of type string, because that's what it is. And here we destructure these things and give it the type props. That fixes the errors, so no red files. And now we will see why we need the sub-URL in the first place. So here we also care about if the user has voted or not. So I also want to know this here. We create a variable as voted, and we filter over our votes from the post. And if we return every item we can find here that's equal to the session.userID, again, we set it up so it's also here available, the user ID. And if it finds something, it has a length. And if this length is greater than zero, the user has voted. Because if it finds one value, he has voted. If not, he hasn't voted yet. And right below here, below where we check our session, we want to create the mutation. So first, when the user has voted, we simply remove the vote from our cache. So if he has voted, we are going to import mutate from, it's also coming from SWR, it's called mutate, and it takes in following arguments. The first one is the sub URL, so it has to be the same key, it's called a key in SWR, as our use SVR here, so it has to be the same key, so it knows it needs to update this store. So this is our store, our state. The first thing is the key. Then it can receive an async function that gives us the current value in our cache. So we could name that, for example, state. That's maybe easier to understand. So we get the current state, and like in React, when we use state in old React in the class component, you remember that, we just return a new state. So we return the current state, but what we want to change, we want to change the posts. We map over our posts. We have the current post in the pipeline. And if the current post, sorry, this is not data, this is state. If the current post.id is equal to the post we are currently in, we will return an updated post with all the values from the current post. And we also are now where the real change happens, because we want to remove the vote, because he already has voted. So in the current post, we are going to filter and what do we filter if the user ID from the vote is not equal to the user ID that's currently logged in. So it returns every vote that's not equal to the user ID. And the one that is equal will not get returned. So it will basically removed. So that's the if case. And we also don't forget to return the current post. If by default we return the current post, because then it should work. Okay, let's save this so it's formatted nicely. And now we can check this out. This will only work when the user has voted. Again, I will set this to zero again so we can see. Okay, so when I click here, it should be zero. Yeah, you see instantly zero. But then SVR refetches it. And yeah, there we have to do another thing here. So we updated our local cache, then we fetch it again, or not, no, we not fetch it again. We set our actual fetch request, and then the database already has the same state as here in local. And to make it to revalidate is the right thing. We revalidate the cache from the database with a simple mutate sub URL. So it refetches the sub with all the things and gets validated with our cache. Everything is correct here. So let's try it by upvoting. Here we haven't implemented yet. We have to manually refresh. When I click, it should be zero and stay zero. Most of undefined. I think that's. I need a hard refresh. So it's one now. Okay. Yeah, it's not perfect right now because we also have to implement the other thing when the user hasn't voted yet. Because then we will add a vote to it. So again, mutate with the sub URL. Again, an async function that receives the state. And here we are going to return the current state. And again, here is where we map over our posts. Get the current post. And that's also the same if the current post.id is equal to the post.id. We return the current post, but also change the votes on it. Here I made an error again, it's state not data. So basically, we want to add. Votes. We want to change the votes. We will spread in all the votes that are already there, but then we create also a new vote. And here we give it a vote type of type that comes from our function here. A user ID of session.userID. The post ID of current post dot ID. This was the if case, and also don't forget else return the current post, otherwise it won't work. And now, wishing everything should work for to be safe, let's restart the server. Let's reopen the server. Write out. You see, it's very much behind a simple upvote button. I didn't, to be honest, I didn't expect it myself that it's so much work and things to think about. To just have a simple upvote button working. Yeah, but that's how it is. And in the next video, we will tackle the downvote button. So let's try it out here. I click upvote. Post is undefined. Don't know why that error came, to be honest. Post is undefined. Let me fix this quickly. Okay, guys, so I looked around and asked around on different forums. Funny enough, I got an answer from awesome Reddit. A guy said he had the same issue, and because use effect takes some time to progress, so sometimes it can be the case that here when we mutate and we get the state, so the cache, this is undefined. I don't know really why, because it shouldn't be undefined in my opinion. Maybe somebody of you knows it, then please write it in the comments. But we will go with his answer. I already tested it out and then it works fine. So we give it state, and if state is undefined, we will give it the full sub. We don't have it right now, but we will receive it here. Full sub. And this is of type, we will import it from here. Summary. Okay, we don't have a type yet, but here we pass in the data from full sub. And here we create full sub. Where did you get payload? What do we need here? Okay, let's just go ahead and grab it here from GitHub. Sub with posts. And then we give it this type. Then everything should work. Another error here. Post votes. Complain doesn't exist. Sorry. Oh yeah, okay. Votes true. Is that one? So now every error is gone. So now we have the full sub. We just pass it in here. And this is the initial state. If it is undefined, it just gets the same state that we already have. Okay. Let's try it from the beginning. Next.js. I also want to fix this error. Yeah, when we click now, everything works. Not really perfect. Oh man, what's going on now? I think that has to do something with the key. Let's have a look. That's an easy fix. Just go here. And the key is the post.id because every post.id is unique. And also one last restart of the server. Lots to cover, a lot to cover. I'm sorry guys that this is so long, but it's so much to do, and we didn't even have download yet. Hopefully this is working now. Nope. There's weird behavior. Fix that. Okay, I found two bugs. One is where TypeScript is really cool. It shows me here there is no property ID, and it's perfectly right because it's uppercase ID. But that isn't the problem. The problem of this weird behavior is because mutate takes a third argument, and that's called if it should try to revalidate here or refetch it. So we have to set this to false. And I will put the mutate API in the description so you can have a good read about it. And in there it will be explained in detail. Yeah, and now it works like expected. So I click, 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 click. Works perfectly now. Splendid. Okay, guys. Whew. That was a long lesson. I hope I wasn't too confusing. Sometimes I even confuse myself. I'm very sorry, but I try to cut all the videos I make to a better understandable long video. And yeah. And last thing I will change before I upload it is just to set this back to 1. And then I will push it to GitHub and you can play around on the live example. Okay, guys, in the next lesson or next video, I will implement downvoting posts. And in a future lesson, this will getting even more complicated when there can also be votes on comments. But we will figure this out together. And yeah, so have a nice day, guys, and see you very soon, hopefully. And take care. Bye bye. Self-dev out.